हेलो, वेलकम बैक टू इकोनॉमिक क्लास विद द चैप्टर पॉवर्टी एज अ चैलेंज। वी हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट कि व्हाट इज पॉवर्टी, व्हाट आर द सोशल इंडिकेटर्स व्हिच आर सेट बाय द सोशल साइंटिस्ट, कि व्हाट देन व्हाट इज सोशल एक्सक्लूजन, व्हाट इज वल्नरेबिलिटी एंड व्हाट इज पॉवर्टी लाइन। आफ्टर दैट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज पॉवर्टी एस्टिमेट। The first thing is that कि what is this poverty estimate? It is a method of determining the poverty line by multiplying minimum subsistence level of food, clothing, footwear, fuel, educational and medical requirements etc. with their prices. It is based on two bases. This poverty estimation is based on two bases: nutritional requirement, that is 2400 calories per person per day in rural areas. Reason is that in rural areas people mostly used to do the farming which require more physical strength, and 2100 in urban areas. Why only 2100 in urban areas per person per day? Because most of the rural people used to do the work in offices which require less physical strength. And second base is consumption expenditure, which is 816 rupees in rural areas, whereas rupees 1000 in urban areas. According to the census of 2011-12, a family of 5 members earning less than 4,080 rupees in rural areas and rupees 5,000 in urban areas per month was considered as poor. Now, we will see about the interstate disparity and global poverty scenario or trend. Here, C is missing in scenario. First, interstate disparity. The poverty is not remaining the same everywhere or in every state in India. It means poverty in India also has another aspect or dimension. The proportion of the poor people is not the same in every state. The reason behind this, why it differs from state to state, is differ. Now, although state level poverty has witnessed a secular decline from the levels of early 70s. Means early 70s mein humne kuch decline dekha tha. The success rate of reducing poverty varies from state to state. Recent estimate shows while all the states HCR was 21.9% in 2011 and 12, states like Madhya Pradesh, Assam, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Orissa had above all Indian poverty level. The graph 3.2 shows, the graph is shown in your book. Bihar and Orissa continue to be the two poorest state with the poverty ratio of 33.7 and 37.6% respectively. Please remember these two states, the poorest states of India, Bihar and Orissa, because most of the time it comes for one marks question. So along with the rural poverty, urban poverty is also very high in these states like Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. We are already talking about the poor states, but there has been a significant decline in poverty in the states like such as Kerala. Why the poverty reduced in Kerala? Because the state like Kerala, Jammu Kashmir had focused on human resource, because they spend on human resource. They are taking care of the education of the people there. Health care and training facilities are provided in these states. Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, West Bengal, states like Punjab and Haryana have traditionally succeeded in reducing poverty. Why the states of Punjab and Haryana have been succeeded in reducing the poverty because of their agricultural reforms or agricultural development. In the same way, in West Bengal, land reforms have been introduced by the state government to reduce the poverty. In the states like Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, they had improved their PDS system. PDS system means public distribution system of food, grain, and then they were able to reduce the poverty from their states. Next topic is global poverty scenario. See, as in case of India, we had already seen that poverty is not same everywhere. We had already seen from Bihar to Himachal Pradesh through graph that poverty ratio differ from one state to another state. In the same way, in world also, it is unequally spread. See, the proportion of the people in developing countries or a nation living in extreme economic poverty. तो ये जो डेवलपिंग नेशंस हैं वहाँ पे पॉवर्टी ज़्यादा है एज इट इज डिफाइंड बाय द वर्ल्ड बैंक एज लिविंग ऑन द लेस देन 1.25 यूएस डॉलर पर डे हैज फॉलन फ्रॉम 43% इन 1992 22% इन 2008 मींस जो ये वर्ल्ड बैंक ने सेट कर रखा है कि इन these developing nation, if a person is not able to earn 1.25 US dollar per day, then he remains the poor, has been declined from 43% to 22%. Although there has been a substantial reduction in global poverty, it is marked with the great regional differences also, as we had seen in case of Asian countries, especially the Southeast Asian countries. These countries has demarked with the rapid economic growth as well as massive investment in human resource development. Yes, that's true. If the country spent money on human capital formation or human resource development, so those countries will rapidly brought a drastic change in their economic growth rate. Or we can see the rapid economic improvement or development in these countries. See, the number of poor in China has come down from 85% in 1981 to 14% in 2008. And according to this 2011, it has come down by 6%. But still, this type of rapid economic growth or development is not seen and observed in the other countries of South Asia like India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bangladesh, Bhutan. Now, see this table 3.2, which will able to tell you what percent of population of these mentioned countries are below poverty line. In Nigeria, 62%, Bangladesh, 43%, India, 25%, Pakistan, 13%, China, 6%, Brazil, 5%, Indonesia, 16%, and Sri Lanka, 4%. See, let us discuss. Two questions are given here. So, graph which is given in your book, with the help of that graph, try to identify the areas of the world where the poverty ratio has declined. And second question is that, try to find out the areas of the world which has the largest concentration of the poor. That's all. In next video, we will talk about the causes of poverty.